Hi, my name is George Firikan, and I'm going to teach you about three different ways to secure funding for your data governance program. In reality, one of the many challenges of starting a data governance program is just this, a lack of funding. But luckily for us, there are three proven ways to secure funding for a data governance program. So let's see what the first one is. And that is to try and make your ask as part of the business case of the data governance program. This is where you briefly describe the drivers, the purpose of the program, and what's aiming to resolve along with its stakeholders, and you put them into this business case document, which some might call a charter, but more about that in a different video. Now, requesting funding through this business case makes your ask strong. And that is because the document itself is already arguing the importance of the data governance program and how it's meant to support your organization's goals. To make it an even more compelling ask, and not just ask for funding to be poured into yet another program, please showcase it as an investment model. Simply put, you'll ask the sponsor or sponsors to invest resources into a program which would yield the organization savings due to things such as an improved quality of data or improvements in the data creation, acquisition, maintenance, dissemination, or other data management practices and processes, or a reduced risk in data privacy and security breaches, and so on. Again, you're asking the sponsor to make an investment which would yield greater savings than the investment itself. Now, if none of this is an option for you, let's take a look at the second one, because another strategy to get that funding is to take a look at what IT projects are currently on the roadmap, which would have data governance as a key success factor. Look at the budget, have a conversation with the project manager, project sponsor, and make sure you add data governance as a budget line item. Projects could include an upgrade or replacement to a customer relationship management tool or an enterprise resource planning system. But there could be many others, such as an enterprise data warehouse or a master data management project or a business intelligence tool and so on. Based on the scope of these projects, make sure you have one or more budget line items dedicated to the data governance resources you need, such as people and tools. The easiest way is to make sure you're going to tie these to other data management deliverables and tools, such as those related to data cleansing and data integration and data transformation, data modeling, data definitions, and so on. If this is not on the table for you either, fear not, because there's a third option. And that option is to make your ask as part of a business project. Now, okay, everything is a business project when you think about it, as it's the business needs driving it, or at least it should be. But I want to separate those projects tied to systems and data flows, i.e. the IT projects we went over before, from those tied to processes and non-technical deliverables. So here are some examples of such projects. You could have an increase of patient flow efficiencies in a healthcare institution, or a delivery of a survey towards a country's citizens to determine current demographics. Or you might have a big complicated marketing campaign or a multi-year fundraising campaign. Or simply ensuring regulatory compliance such as GDPR, FIPA, HIPAA, PCI, and many others. Or you might have a merger between two or more departments or an acquisition of another organization. The list can go on and on. These are usually tactical or strategic projects, but with at least a data component, which would require data governance. In fact, the project charter or the project scope document should list a lack of data governance as a risk to project failure. In closing, let's do a quick recap on the three ways to get this funding that you need for your data governance program. The first and preferred one is to make it as part of the business case, as this solidifies the ongoing commitment into the data governance program. If that is not an option, you can either have it as part of an IT project, such as a CRM ERP deployment, or a business project, such as a fundraising campaign, a process improvement, some sort of a regulatory compliance project. Now, if you're tapping into any of these two last options, be advised that these are projects with a specific end date. And so the funding for your data governance program, because it's tied to the funding of these projects, might have an end date as well. The solution? You either place it as a recurring budget line item, if that's an option, or you look for other sources of funding once that project has ended. Ideally though, by the end of the project, data governance would have proven its worth and start receiving its own dedicated budget going forward. If you found this useful, check out LightsOnData.com for more informative content on data governance and data management practices. Here you can find free templates, definitions, best practices, articles, and other useful resources to help you with your data governance and data management questions and challenges. So please follow, subscribe, or sign up for the monthly newsletter to never miss out on great content. And don't forget to like and comment. Until next time, my name is George Firikan. Thank you.